unifying aspect of Filipino culture is that we Filipinos love to eat. We eat when we're happy, sad, bored, angry, and of course, when we're hungry. While the usual restaurants are available on every block to satisfy these cravings, there are also street stalls serving up an array of cheap, tasty, and albeit strange snacks as well. But what may seem as an acceptable daily income for street food vendors does not mean it's acceptable for people's health.
It is very apparent that many Filipinos are struggling from economic instability today, and many are suffering from hunger and malnutrition. Changing lifestyles and family structures here in Baguio City have meant changing eating habits, and this has led to the increased popularity of the not-so-healthy, but convenient, cheap, tasty, authentic, and culturally enriching food, popularly known as street food. Street food is ready-to-eat foods or beverages sold in busy public areas, along streets, near school premises, parks, and other public places. Some street foods are already cooked and many times reheated, while others are cooked on the spot. Some street foods have unique names. Adidas is marinated chicken's feet, while the head is called helmet. IUD, or commonly known as isaw, are chicken intestines on a stick and is surprisingly a street favorite. The cubed curdled blood of a chicken is called Betamax, named after the shape and look of a Betamax tape. Let's not forget the good old barbecue made from either pork or chicken, marinated in soy sauce and calamansi, and cooked over charcoal. Fish balls and squid balls are made from flaked fish or squid mixed with flour. Kikiam is minced fish rolled into balls and made with ground pork and vegetables. All of these popular street foods are complemented with different sauce or condiments, like vinegar with onions, to sweet and spicy sauce. The boiled fertilized duck eggs is a Filipino treat called balot. A hot, delicious noodle soup inappropriate to the city's climate is called mami. A bestseller in the city's parks is a taho, with the ingredients of bean custard mixed with caramel syrup and tapioca pearls, or what is locally known as sago. Strawberry flavor is also available for an extra charge. A city street food special is the binatog. It is made of boiled white kernel corn, flavored by white sugar and evaporated milk, topped off with grated coconut. Other street foods that can be found in Baguio City are bituka, roasted or boiled corn on the cob, dirty ice cream, mangga with alamang or shrimp paste, kwek-kwek, peanuts, and many more. Let's watch how these street foods are being prepared. Some members of our crew visited 19-year-old Joseph Alejandro and his family. His job is to cook, slice, and prepare the ready-to-cook street foods which are being sold along Tranquilville. For him and his family, it's their means of livelihood. All the assorted meats are first boiled until they are tender. Food coloring is also added to make the meat look attractive for buyers and to cover the discoloration of the meat after boiling. Then finally, they are placed on sticks. While these tasty treats are being prepared, his mother and some others prepare the sauce which will be used as dipping for the street foods. After all is prepared, his mother, sister, and cousin ready the street foods for transporting, not by any means of transportation, but just by simply walking. For many years, vended street foods have mushroomed all throughout the city's streets, enticing a diverse age category, mostly students from elementary to college. However, little do they know that eating these tantalizing treats may possibly poison them due to the lack of sanitation in food preparation. Undeniably, there are health risks and issues about the social scenario, so we visited the City Health Office to find out more. City Health Nutrition Officer Dr. Angelita T. Sabado talks about the risks about eating street foods.
I think the main risk that we have to consider in eating street foods is the sanitation of the food, no? The way it was prepared, where it came from, and of course, is it sanitary as it is presented along the streets? No? We see a lot of these foods that are just plainly open and out, and disregarding yung ating tinuturo sa kanila na they should always try to cover. What we hear about is, of course, yung sumasakit lang yung tiyan, no? Yung mga ganun, but not really very serious. But some of them are really, maybe they get this from some of our street foods that are not properly cooked. So yun, I know of one who ate this, what do you call that, yung head of a chicken. And that's really very dangerous because it's covered with bones, and the one that's inside, that's the one that gets rotten. And you don't see that.
Many students would say that street foods made from meat is a source of protein. But Dr. Sabado contradicts this notion. She advises that it should be eaten with a main dish. She also pointed out that students are popular customers of street foods. And what is sad about this is it replaces their lunch and dinner, which in this case should not be. The most common symptoms of food poisoning include diarrhea, watery stools, abdominal cramps, nausea, vomiting, and fever.
Mahilig kasi akong kumain ng street foods dati. Tapos, kasi nga nursing student ako, kaya may mandatory medical exam. Tapos dun ko nga nalaman na may tapeworm ako. Nagreseta sila ng anti-tapeworm, kaya nagpurga ako mga 2 weeks yun. After 2 weeks naman, nag-negative naman ako dun ng parasitic infection. Kaya okay na.
So, hindi ka, I mean, simula ba nun, ayaw mo lang kumain ng street food?
Medyo. Siyempre, nag-stop mo lang kumain ng street foods after nun. Pero siguro mga 1 year, kumain ulit ako. Pero konti lang.
So, hindi ka na trauma dun sa tapeworm na yun?
Medyo lang.
We were also able to interview Committee on Health and Sanitation City Councilor Erdolfo Balahaja.
We are sometimes focusing attention on street foods because we would like to control how the street food is prepared, who are preparing it, are they healthy, are they sick, do they practice sanitary methods in preparing street foods. The food should be sanitarily prepared, it should be clean, should be safe to eat, and the preparation should be safe, and that the one selling or vending should also be healthy.
Matagal na ba kayo nagbibenta?
Matagal na ba?
Hanggang anong oras kayo?
Hanggang alas 5 kami na to, hanggang alas 12.
Marami pang bumibili. Ano yung kadalasang binibili ng mga tao?
A licensed street food vendor is required to get a health certificate. Health workers, including the City Health Office, conducts a daily inspection of the foods to find out if they are protected from contamination and if they are prepared sanitarily in order to protect school children and even adults who buy them. Before anyone can sell, they undergo seminars for food preparation, food protection, and on their health as vendors. It is mandatory that a street food vendor should not work while he is sick. However, we cannot ignore the fact that vendors can be stubborn and at times do not follow these rules. As we visited the City Hall's Research Division, we found out that Resolution Number 088 Series of 2005 states that side street vendors, karinderias, and other similar food stalls selling or serving ready-to-eat or cooked foods are required to encase food items in safe containers or glass display casings to protect them from contamination and other health hazards such as dust and smog from passers-by and vehicles including airborne bacteria and viruses. Baguio City's health situation is a byproduct of the people's social condition. Currently, many city residents are unaware of the detrimental effects of eating street foods on their health. Indeed, street foods have already become a part in our way of life. Our much busier lifestyle had affected our choices in food. Let's help ourselves live healthy through proper diet and exercise.
Street foods will always be part of our culture. Even with the risks, we cannot stop people from buying and consuming these snacks. All we aim for is moderation in eating street foods, for we always believe in the saying, prevention is better than cure. We must always remember that our health is priceless and we should not sacrifice it for just a 5 peso stick of street food. I'm Karen Lazo. Thank you for watching.